Attention viewer, you are watching the world's biggest Monster Truck Diecast YouTube channel. This is Monster Jam OCT.
Well, hello everyone and welcome back to another Monster Jam OC video. Today is yet another before the show for review video for Series or Mix 13. Now, this is due for August 25th, and I'm actually recording this video on April 29th. So we're in the current time that I'm recording this, we're way away from that time. But this is due for August 25th, so it's kind of our later year releases and some of the best stuff, I gotta say, in this mix alone. Next mix, Mix 14, has the strongest mix in my opinion, so I can't wait to review that. But right now, in my current time on April 29th, I actually do not have Mix 12, but I do have Mix 13. So you'll hear me reference a few things as if they're already done in the future. We're starting here today. I want to start with this one because I think it's the best just to get out of the way. This is the Retro Rebels Gravedigger. And as you can see, it has the Retro Rebel symbol, the Gravedigger tag. The Series 13's assortment color is actually green instead of the classic yellow. I'm not sure if Mix 12, since I don't have it yet, had a different color, but we'll know by the time this review comes out. We're going to unbox this right now and take a look at the poster and this truck. Here we go. And this truck is one of my least favorites of Mix 13 and actually of the entire year. But after thinking about it some more and kind of weighing what they did with this and the option that they had, I get why they did this. Some countries, and actually a majority of them that I've heard of, did not receive the Gravedigger 5-pack, which you guys know it came in the Gravedigger 5-pack last year for Target, and that pack is still running currently in Target stores in the United States. It will continue to do so until late this year. But some countries did not have that option because they don't have Target stores, or their Target stores in their countries just didn't order them. I get what they're doing now. They're getting the product that people want out there again, and that's totally cool. However, I still feel like the Retro Rebels series is one of the big collector-based series that a lot of people look to for throwback items and those nostalgic trucks. And having a truck that we just had released again is iffy to me still. But I do enjoy the fact that they did upgrade this Gravedigger version, which is the newer one, with the black bumper, because the real life truck did have a black bumper, not a gray one. So we do have an accurate version now of the Gravedigger red primer, but in a way it's the same exact thing as the one we got in the 5-pack. But this gives me a great opportunity to pivot. First off, actually the wristband, which is a Gravedigger red wristband. You can see the logos there, which is really cool. But it gives me a chance to pivot to the Mix 13 poster, which has the just awesome, it's my favorite truck of this mix and one of my favorite trucks, if not my favorite of the year, on the back, which is the Backwards Bob throwback. So Backwards Bob, if you guys are new fans to Monster Jam, you might not have known about Backwards Bob, but Backwards Bob was a truck that ran for, I think it was like 5 or 6 years, and then it retired sadly, but it was the only truck to have its body mounted backwards to give the illusion that it was driving backwards. And this is an old photo of it. You can see the tires aren't BKTs. It did run during the BKT tire era for a very, very brief time. And you can see there it is crushing a car. There's the body mounted backwards, and you'll see that truck in a moment in Mix 13. And then here's the actual poster for Mix 13, the lineup. We have Racing Stripes, Zombie Boneyard Trucks, the Megalodon Ride Truck, Tropical Thunder, Thrasher, Legacy Trucks, which was a switch from the original Arena Favorites where it was before that. We have the Heroes and Villains Trucks Superman, the Retro Rebels Gravedigger Red, Backwards Bob Retro Rebels, and the Reckless Trucks El Toro Loco. And here is the Zombie. So this is Mix 13, the next Boneyard Trucks, and we're gonna unbox this thing right now. And I will make a couple notes about this. One, I enjoy how well the Boneyard Trucks theme fits this specific truck. Obviously, a zombie is part of that ghoulish Halloween theme, horror movie theme, ideology, and obviously this roll cage idea, which is having a roll cage made of human and or maybe animal bones, but it looks like human bones to me, is really awesome. And you can see the roll cage is a bright bone color. We have a rib cage for the motor. We have a mouth on the front of the chassis here. The shocks are spinal discs, and the crossbars are a bunch of different bones. So it's a really cool theme. I enjoy the tire color as well. They did a bone color tire. So here's Zombie. The decals are the same as a usual Zombie, as I can compare it to this Zombie here. The same decals. Actually, the Zombie on the left is a little more updated. It has better decal quality than this Zombie. But anyway, the decals are the same. I'm just trying to prove that to you guys. So nothing's changed. And here comes my critical point about this. I wish they would have taken this opportunity to make the skeleton Zombie from the World Finals 15 or 16 Encore. It's been so long now, and I've been asking for these trucks for so many years, it's hard to even remember. I think it's World Finals 15 Encore Zombies, which were the ones that were out during the Red Light Encore. You couldn't see anything, and by the time we did see them, most of the Zombie bodies that were debuting that night were destroyed. However, Skeleton Zombie did survive that whole Encore and did run for a few shows under Bari Musaur, and then it retired fully. But Skeleton Zombie would have been a perfect truck to fit this Boneyard truck series. However, I think they pivoted away from doing it because it requires a new tooling of the face, which would be the indented nose, the hairless body, and then the arm. I believe it's this arm that's half cut. So it's cut pretty much from the top of the hand to about the elbow of the arm. So I get that as well. Tooling costs for that specific truck probably was not available for this, or they just didn't think of doing it, or they're saving it for something else, which I hope that's the case, because I really think those Zombie trucks deserve a big spotlight after not being made by any company so far. So anyway, there it is, the Boneyard truck Zombie, and it has a maroon wristband, same color as Gravedigger, but with the MonsterGM.com instead. And next on our list of reviews, it is the Tropical Thunder independent truck, which has not been seen for a long, long time. So we're gonna unbox it right now. The Tropical Thunder, which is a returning independent that Hot Wheels did produce. They did produce this body style during their time with the contract. And now we are receiving it one more time with an accurate updated look, which includes a grill and headlight printing and the accurate Tour Accurate beadlocks and rims. So blue beadlocks on the gray rims, which was a real feature of this truck during its time. I believe it retired and is no longer run, but it's cool that the independent team did agree to have their truck made one more time through the Spinmaster contract. You might not notice this, but they went full measure and actually printed taillights, even though you can't really see them. You could tell the darker color. And now we're getting to the bigger ones here. We have the Thrasher truck, which is actually a brand new tooling for 2020. The first ever Toyota Tundra tooling for the Monster Jam diecast line. And let's just check it out right now. Here we go. When the poster was revealed, this was a big one and a hot spot for collectors because we have never received a Toyota Tundra tooling by any diecast company. And Thrasher, during its time on the circuit, which it has retired since that time, it did run some standard pickup truck bodies, but it did switch to the Toyota Tundra tooling during the last portion of its time as a monster truck. So Thrasher, again, has never received this tooling before, but Spinmaster went out of their way to make a retired independent with a new tooling, which required a Toyota contract, which is just absolutely crazy. It does come with a darker orange wristband to match the truck. I'll just get that out of the way real quick. But here it is, the Toyota Tundra Tooling Thrasher by Spinmaster. This body style as well, the black and orange, was never made by Mattel. They did produce the red and blue and the red and green, but they never went to do the black and orange, which happens to be my favorite paint scheme of Thrasher. So it's really nice to finally see it come out with this paint scheme. I think it looks awesome. And you can see the detail of the casting. It has a door handle, which is 3D. I'm trying to get the details caught in the light. It's hard to see. Let me zoom out a little bit. There we go. But there it is there. And you can see the beadlocks are dark orange beadlocks with the gray rims. We have the front, same thing. The grill printed in with the headlights, the Thrasher creature on the hood. And then the roof has those indentations, really nice, black and orange. The chassis is gray, the roll cage is black. The tailgate actually does have the website for Toyota of Wallingford on there with the, again, the website link, which does work to this date. So that's pretty cool. And then they have a little negative space bar for stabilization. This side, same stuff. And that is the Thrasher. And next up is a superhero truck. So let's unbox it. Check it out right now. And as I mentioned in my Mix 11 review, which included the Batman tooling. These are the only current concepts that were created solely by the Spin Master design team. These are not coming to real life to my knowledge because Monster Jam does not have the DC contract, but Spin Master can make them in a joint agreement, I assume, with Monster Jam. So you can see we do have two brand new bodies for these trucks. These have never been done before. These, again, were created by Spin Master design team themselves, not by Monster Jam, although I'm sure they had some kind of collaborative work with them. It was mostly based around the Spin Master design team. So it's really cool to see their first ever, as you would call them, the original concepts, as we call them with Hot Wheels, Hot Wheels originals. I guess you would call these Spin Master originals as well. So this is the Batman. We already reviewed that one. So today focuses a lot more around the new Superman, which I really like this design. I'm not going to say it's my favorite of the Superman designs of the past because I did enjoy Man of Steel. I also enjoyed original Superman, and I hope that Spin Master is able to revisit those bodies in the future. But I like this. I really do. You can see it does have laser eyes for headlights, which is a detail I didn't catch until someone pointed it out to me. So there are lasers coming out of the headlights because I believe Superman has laser vision as one of his, I guess you would call it, his weapons. So you can see there's lasers coming out of the headlights, which if you could imagine this is a real life truck, it would have these lasers lit up, which would be amazing. The front grille is super detailed. There's a lot of 3D casting work around this entire truck. There's the Superman logo. A theme with the Superman, or the superhero trucks, I should say, with Spin Master is to just have their emblem, except for Wonder Woman, which I believe does not have just an emblem. It has the name, but Superman has just the logo. You can see right there, it has the Monster Jam logo. A lot more 3D casting work. It has a curved back here, but this curve does not create a circular tailgate like Wonder Woman. It kind of cuts off into a straight edged tailgate here. You can see the DC contract trademark on the back, and then a full die-cast metal cape on here as well, molded into the pickup truck itself, and a little back window, which is pretty cool too. So there it is, that side, and the same thing on this side. And on the hood here, we do have a 3D Superman logo, some more 3D details, an interesting cut into the windshield, and then a nice roof panel, a red roll cage, chrome chassis, and blue rims. It also comes with a dark blue wristband to match the truck. Here we go. And next on our review list, it's the brand new horse-themed truck, although this is a zebra. It's not really a horse, but they are very similar in shape to a horse. So Spin Master has taken the horsepower tooling, and also you would call it the Sparkle Smash tooling, and reused it yet again. So the first horsepower tooling casting came from Horsepower itself, which was in 2019's Mix 7 assortment. And then following that in Mix 8 was the new concept for the Unicorn, also known as Sparkle Smash, which features a unicorn insert here with some wispy magical hair for the mane and the tail similar. So every time we see these, there's a new casting insert for the mane and the tail. So you can see it's more of a horse style here. Then we have this magical fairy tale like mane with a multicolored top. And now we have the zebra. So Racing Stripes, the zebra, seeing it in person has changed the way the original design looked. There's a lot more detail that the render does not show, like all this shadowing in the fur of the animal itself. So you can see, if I get the lighting better, there we go. You can see all the shadowing in the actual stripes itself or themselves. And there's the logo there, really nice logo, Monster Jam logo. The front here, the same mouth, but a different color for this part here. It's a much darker black, dark grayish color. The teeth are colored in obviously with the mouth and the windshield. The top here, the stripes all match up perfectly. It has a multicolored ear, or multicolored ears with black interior and white exterior. Now, since they did this, I think they can definitely do Scooby-Doo's with the pink inside. I hope they do that in the future. And then if we zoom out a little bit, you can see the top of the mane, which is a brand new zebra-shaped mane, which if you guys have ever seen zebras before, which I'm pretty sure most of you probably have, they have a very specific style mane. It's very almost rectangular in its shape. So they did capture that on this truck with a brand new insert piece and a brand new tail insert piece as well to match a real life zebra tail. It also has the bright white beadlocks with a black inner rim and the black tires, chrome chassis, and black roll cage. So that is the Racing Stripes, and it also comes with the first, I believe, white wristband for Spin Master Monster Jam. And next on the review list is the Reckless Trucks El Toro Loco. And this is the next Reckless Trucks edition from the Reckless Trucks series. We did have in Mix 12 again, which I do not have on hand, Reckless Trucks Gravedigger, which looks absolutely insane from the pictures that I've seen up to this point in time. But this is the next one and the final one for this year, which is El Toro Loco. And the first one we received was Salvager, but Salvager is a custom concept that is not a real life truck. So this is one of the two real life editions of the Reckless Truck series. So as I mentioned in Salvager's review, and I'll likely mention in the Gravedigger review, these are basically just junkyard panels put together into a new monster truck. So basically we're taking retired El Toro Loco bodies and putting them into a junkyard themed truck. So on this left side panel, we have a lot of rust. You can see that they did not keep the body plain. They did add a lot of rust tones, lots of rust and dirt. We have the orange El Toro Loco cab, the hood of orange El Toro Loco, which I'll get to in a second, and the left side fender of black El Toro Loco. And that's kind of a hint towards a future black El Toro Loco if they ever make one, which I'm sure they will at some point. And there's a taillight on that side. We have yellow El Toro Loco represented on the tailgate, the full tailgate of yellow El Toro Loco, monsterjam.com, the purple flames, red logo, lots of rust. And as you can see, they did not add a taillight on both sides. They actually changed it up a little bit. I guess you would say it's more junkyard styled without just a uniform looking taillight. So they got one taillight missing. And then on this side, we have a right fender of the orange El Toro Loco, monsterjam logo, the cab of yellow El Toro Loco with the purple flames. And then again, like I said, the hood of orange El Toro Loco, and then the chin strap area of the black El Toro Loco with the red fur, which is a real life, or chin hairs, which is a real life feature of black El Toro Loco before it retired. And the roof is also black El Toro Loco's roof with the dark yellow horns with a slight purple color, and then a rusty front part of the flames. So it's got like a rusty flame color as well. And then a negative space bar with a full matte clear coat, which is very nice. I think that that's the best thing they could have done for this. And black roll cage. And then we have a back right yellow rim, a front right gray or silver rim. We have on this side, the left front is the orange, a bright fluorescent orange. And on the back left, we have the purple rim. And for me, this review really has come down all to this. This is my favorite truck of this mix and possibly my favorite truck of the year. It depends how well Joker's done. But Backwards Bob is one of my favorite trucks that ever existed for many different reasons. But I love the idea that it actually looks like it's driving backwards. It's one of the most unique ideas that they've ever had in Monster Jam. It's very disappointing to see it retired, but hopefully one day they do bring it back at some point. So I am really eager to open this. So I'm just going to go right into it. We're going to unbox Backwards Bob for 2020 right now. And if you guys have watched my channel for a while, you probably know that I'm a huge Backwards Bob fan. Obviously, like I mentioned in the poster part of the video, it has retired since that time, and I really miss it. I hope they bring it back one day. It's such a unique idea. And it comes with a decent colored yellow wristband between the two tones we had earlier. So here's the different colors. We have the Backwards Bob, we have El Toro Loco, and then we have the bright fluorescent Tropical Thunder. So those are the wristbands. No one really cares as much about the wristbands as they do about Backwards Bob, I'm sure. So here is the truck itself, Backwards Bob, actual Backwards Bob this time, not a forward-facing packaged Backwards Bob. And I am just thrilled with how it turned out. Obviously, trucks have their motors, if they're packaged in a Spin Master packaging, they have their motors facing towards the right. So you can see this is how it looks. You can see the motors facing towards the right, which usually is not a feature of a pickup truck because a pickup truck would face their motor and the front grille faces towards the right. But on Backwards Bob, since it is a backwards idea of a truck, we have the motor facing the opposite way of the hood. So for Spin Master, they did take the pickup truck tooling. They added the extended cab, which is something people wanted for a normal pickup truck, which they have not done yet, but I hope they do. They have the Backwards Bob decals, which are perfectly accurate. The Monster Jam logo. They did not add taillights, which I hope they do in future editions. And they did not add a grill, which I also hope they do in future editions. But most of it's pretty much exactly how the real life truck was. And we have the new headlights, which are, I think, a new decal. I think actually Tropical Thunder had those as well. But it's one of the newer decals for headlights. You can see the motor again facing the correct way. And then the front here, which does not have a clear tailgate or a removed tailgate. And I'll get to that in just a moment. But we also have the driver here. You can see him looking out. And we have a double windshield. So they did add one windshield here for the regular windshield. the false windshield, as we call it, and then a double windshield, which was a real-life feature of Backwards Bob to protect the driver from any debris. So there it is, the double windshield added in there for this casting. And then we have a slight negative space bar, but I enjoy the fact that they looked at the driver's sight line. So if the driver was staring out, he would be looking about this height. And they actually did not put a negative space bar at the top here. They lowered it down for the driver's sight line right there. But they had to add it for stabilization because the casting would bend. People are asking about this, and I actually realized and I found out that this was a real feature. This here was added to the real life truck to prevent the fenders from breaking during impact, because sometimes the truck would not run a tailgate at all. And the fenders would break. So they added this little crossbar here on the real truck with those two bolts on each side. You see these little bolts here to prevent that fender from bending. And I originally thought this was just to prevent this truck from bending, but seeing these little bolts, I was kind of curious, and it was a real feature. So they took that tiny little detail of the real life truck and added it to this version of the diecast. So they went above and beyond really with this truck. They went beyond any expectation I had for Backwards Bob. They really could have just taken the normal pickup truck tooling, put it backwards on a chassis, and that would have worked fine. But they did go ahead and make double windshields. They added the crossbar, even the little bolts that held in the crossbar. And they also added these accurate beadlocks, which are blue, or I'm sorry, render accurate beadlocks, which are blue, and a gray rim. The real life truck did not run those colors, but I think that it would be awesome if it returns to have those ones. And then we come to the back here, which is the tailgate. The real life truck, like I mentioned, either ran a clear tailgate or no tailgate at all. If they removed the tailgate from this truck, they would have to add a much thicker negative space bar, which would remove this crossbar detail. And the Lexan or clear tailgate, unfortunately, it was too expensive to do for this model, so they did not get that done for this one. But I can forgive it because they did do such extreme additional details like that, this the entire casting, the extended cab. But I also enjoy that they added in this square here to represent the tailgate. They made it gray like the windshield color, because that's how the real life truck had it. It was the same material as the windshield, so it was a little darker gray. And then they added Here I Come, which was never a real life feature. It's kind of a render feature and a video game feature. So in future editions, maybe they'll take that off and use that regular tailgate just by itself. But those are just little updates for it in the future. Also, I think the real life truck had black window panels with these arrows on top of them. But for the first release, I mean, I am thrilled. They're really, for this render accurate version of Backwards Bob, there is nothing to complain about. And here's the fourth ride truck of the six that are getting released this year, which is the highly anticipated Megalodon. And this is one of the last, actually, this is the last real life currently running ride truck that they are producing. As you know, in Mix 10, we received the Gravedigger ride truck, which is a real ride truck with the retro tires. And we also received my favorite current one, and I don't think it's going to change, which is the BKT ride truck. As you guys know, it is also a real life truck. And we also have the Blue Thunder, which is my only Mix 12 truck I currently have. They gave it to me out of the box, which uses the same casting as BKT, which was a real truck, but not with this specific paint scheme, but it did become BKT in real life, although this paint scheme was never used. So Blue Thunder, I wouldn't count as a real life truck, but it is a throwback to the real one. But the three that are being produced that are real currently at the time are Gravedigger, BKT, and of course, the Megalodon. And Megalodon debuted at the Thunder Alley displays at select roller coaster parks during last year's Thunder Alley season. And it did, I believe, run a few pit parties during this last Moss Jam season before it was cut short. So here is Megalodon, and I do have one out of the box thanks to the team to review instead of opening this one. So I will preserve this one on the shelf alongside my other ride trucks. But here is the Megalodon ride truck out of the box, and it's so cool. I think that this is probably one of the best castings they've done for ride trucks yet. I loved BKT, but this is even more accurate than BKT. Gravedigger, however, was pretty much spot on. Same with this one. In terms of the actual casting, I'll talk about the seats in a second, but you can see it does have a new casting. It's not the same casting as the regular Megalodon. It does have extended details, a little sized up for the real life features as the casting is in real life. And you can see the fins are different. They're way smaller than the regular Megalodon. And then we have the double fins, which is a real life feature. And yeah, so this is the Megalodon, and it does have a giant hood, and I think it has actually more teeth up here in the front. It also has gray rims with the BKT tires, the Leafer chassis, the stairs are still on there, and then the seats. So the seats are the one thing about this truck that is not accurate, and I guess you would consider this not an accurate truck because of it, but the casting work is accurate, the seats are not. The seats in the real life Megalodon do face forward, they don't face each other, so it's a little different take on Megalodon. It's because I'm sure it was too expensive to do another tooling, which I totally forgive because they did 5 different die-cast toolings for the ride trucks, including 2 seat castings because Gravedigger uses different seats. But yeah, it's close enough in my opinion. It is a ride truck Megalodon, and I'm not going to go that extreme with the detail of those, but it would be nice to see a Thunder Alley pack with accurate Megalodon with the blue seats facing forward, and then an accurate Gravedigger number 40, which is not this edition of Gravedigger, but the new ride truck Gravedigger, which has a giant hood, forward facing seats as well. It's way different than this one. Very similar in the shape up here, but in the hood, it's way different. And it would be a really nice addition alongside an accurate Megalodon for a Thunder Alley, maybe 2-pack or a playset or something like that to advertise that. But anyway, here's Megalodon one more time before we sign out. Really nice truck. I enjoy it. One of my favorite ride trucks, but BKT still takes the top seed for the ride trucks currently. But I want to hear your guys' opinions. They want to hear your guys' opinions. So please comment below. Let us know what your favorite trucks from Mix 13 were. What are some of your favorites? What don't you like about them? Let them know all your feedback in the comments, and we'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys for watching. It's a Random Monstrum OCD signing out.